Hey guys, so today is going to be my first attempt at doing these hair vlogs. Today is actually the 3rd of January, so it's the first Sunday in the month, the first Sunday in the year. And I plan on perming my hair today. As you can see, please forgive me for looking like hella tired. It's about 8 o'clock now, and I just got off work at 7. So that's the reality of these vlogs, like just to show you how hard it is sometimes to be consistent on your hair journey. But I'm gonna try my hardest to be consistent on my hair journey this year and also consistent with these vlogs. So underneath my silk cap right now, it's just my hair, and I have my clip-ins in, and my clip-ins have been in for about 2 weeks. I don't think that's a really good idea, because I'm pretty sure my hair has a lot of heat damage now, because I was wearing it like part in the middle and straight, and I was doing a lot of flat ironing because the style is so easy, you just like flat iron and go. But a lot of times when I was in a rush, I was flat ironing without any heat protectant, so like my natural hair that's mixed in with the clip-ins, I'm pretty sure I got some heat damage. If you don't know what clip-ins are, I'm gonna show you. I love clip-ins. I've probably been wearing them for about 3 years now. But today these need to come out and my hair needs to perm. My hair needed to relax before. My hand is getting tired doing this vlog. I think I'm just gonna put this on the tripod. 1 minute, you guys. Alright, you guys, so I moved like to a different part of my bedroom because I don't have any special lighting up, but I moved closer to my bedroom window, so I think the lighting is a little bit better. But yeah, so I was talking about my clip-ins and me having to take them out because they've been in for 2 weeks now. So I'm going to take them out. I'm just going to take out the clip-ins. Now, with the clip-ins, there's two ways that you could put these in. One of the ways is just clipping it into your hair. Some beauticians apply it that way, and then some apply it by rolling like a cornrow or braid through your hair, and then like they'll have your hair out and then a braid, and then your hair out and then a braid, like that. So these clip-ins that I have in now are installed that way because it was just easier for the beautician to do it that way. So these are the clip-ins, guys. And they just have the clips on here. Steel clip or metal clip. Alright, so this is what the clip-ins look like, and they just clip on your hair. These are pretty easy to make. I made my own. So yeah, I'm gonna just go ahead and take out my clip-ins now and then get some sleep, and then I'll be back when I relax and treat my hair for you guys. Alright. Alright guys, so I've just loosed out all of the braids that were in my hair. I don't know if you could see, like I do have a lot of new growth. So now that it's all cleared out, like I said, I'm just gonna put my silk bonnet back on it, and then I'm gonna sleep for probably about an hour to allow my scalp to like cool down so it doesn't burn too much when I go to relax it. But I did experience a lot of shedding, which is usually expected when you lose your braids out. If it's been braided for a while, because you know you're supposed to lose like 100 strands like every day or something like that. So I did experience some shedding, but I also noticed some breakage. If you don't know the difference, shedding is almost where you can see like the white pulp. I wish I had saved some of it. You'd see like the white pulp at the end of your hair, and breakage is where you just see, you could literally see like where the hair snapped. And I think that's what happened because I, like I said earlier, was using a lot of heat. So yeah, I'm just gonna put my hair up in this silk bonnet, catch me a nap asleep, and then I'll be back. Hey guys, so I'm up now, probably looking even more scarier than before. But I'm gonna get in a little dress or something to begin this perming process. That was a good sleep. Alright guys, so I just went and threw on like a little house dress, but I just wanted to show you guys some of the products that I'll be using today. Starting with the Vaseline. You guys probably know what this is for, but this is actually to base my hair so that it doesn't burn when I apply the perm. I also use the Organic Root Stimulator. They have like this base, but when I don't have that, then I will use Vaseline. Next is the ORS Olive Oil Cream Relaxer. I usually get this in normal, you guys. Just trying to see if it'll focus. Alright, there you go. So I get it like in normal strength, because recently this relaxer has been like burning my scalp really, really quickly, and it just has not been perming my hair. Like, the middle of my hair just would not break down. So I don't know, I'm about to soon switch out of this, but I already bought like this professional tub, so I have to use all this up, and then I'm gonna find me another relaxer to switch over to. Over here I'm gonna be using the Organic Root Stimulator Creamy Aloe Shampoo, and this is their neutralizing shampoo. Actually, when you relax your hair, let's see if you can see where it says that. So somewhere down at the bottom it would say that. Yeah, right there, it neutralizes. So this is their neutralizing shampoo, so when I'm washing out my relaxer, I'm gonna wash with that. And then afterwards, I am going to deep condition, protein condition with the replenishing conditioner, because I still love this stuff. And then I have just a little bit left of my ElastiQP DPR conditioner there. I just have a little bit more left of that. So I will be using this as my moisturizing conditioner so I can finish this up and then go ahead and get another one. And behind all these stuff, guys, behind all these stuff is this hair wrap, cordless thermal heat wrap. I got this a few months ago. I wanted to do like a hair journey haul or add this to my hair journey haul, but I didn't get around to it, so I'll just show you it in this video. I got this from my girl Ashana at All You 242, and I think this was like $50. But yeah, what it is, and I'll show you guys, you just kind of heat up the heating pads in the microwave, and it's good for deep conditioning instead of you having to use a hair dryer, which is perfect especially if you don't want to add heat to your hair, which is a big part of my hair journey. I only have like one heat pass a month, so I wouldn't want to use it up during deep conditioning. So this is pretty cool for that. I'll show you how this works. And then I just have my combs here just to clear out a rat tail, fine tooth comb to part. And then I also have my Elastic UP leave-in conditioner, but this is this is after I've already like relaxed my hair, deconditioned it, it's air drying. I'll apply that, and then I think I have some, and then here I have some shower caps. All right guys, so I'm just gonna base my hair, my own hair now, because I don't really know how to perm my own hair. I mean, I guess I know, but I've never done it before. I always have someone do it for me, so I'm gonna let my aunt do it for me. She usually does if I don't go like to a salon. But I'm gonna base it myself. I've supposed to been basing it, but I got distracted. I got my laptop down here, and so I'm just, I posted it today, Sunday, so a new video went up on my channel today, so I'm just like checking up on it and then sharing it on my Facebook page, so give me a minute. Now I can start basing my hair. Alright guys, so I've already part my hair in two, but I'm going to try and part my hair in four to base it. Alright guys, so I'm back. I'm a little upset because my aunt like put the perm a little too low down my hair. I usually like just to stay up there to break it down, but I'm gonna sit and leave this on for a minute, well not like a literal minute, but for a little while so that it can actually break down, because like I said, I've been putting this organic root stimulator in my hair from I started my hair journey. It was working well, and then like now I guess my hair got used to it, and that's something you will realize on your hair journey. Like you'll start to see what works for your hair and then what doesn't work for your hair anymore, and then you may need to switch up products. So I think now I may need to start switching up the relaxer that I use, because clearly my hair is just drinking this and it's not breaking it down. I do feel it burning just slightly, but I'm trying to use mind over matter and not really pay attention to that. That's not good because you don't want your hair to be like over processed, but I know mine isn't over processed because it was really, really thick when I took out the clip-ins and took out the side braids, and like I said, it needed to relax for a while now. I am going to be recording this relaxed state. As you know, I stretch my hair at least 10 to 12 weeks. I'm going to try to go to 12 weeks and then go to like 14 weeks and 16 weeks and kind of keep stretching my hair longer. So yeah, I'm just going to let this sit for a minute and let my hair break down, and then I'll be back when I begin the washing process, or at least the deep conditioning process, because I don't feel like me in and out of the shower washing this out, and then on camera washing it out, like that's gonna be too much work. Alright guys, so I'm out of the shower, and I rinsed out the relaxer. I think my hair took like it break down, but it's burning, it burned in the back, like in the back here I could still feel the new growth where it didn't break down. But I'm going to comb out my hair, starting from the bottom, working it up to the top just to clear out the hair. And then I'm going to apply the replenishing conditioner and cover it with a shampoo cap, or a shower cap. And then I'm going to go into my thermal head wrap for 45 minutes. You have the option of doing it 15 to 30 minutes, but my hair really needs the treatment, so I'm going to do it for the 45 minutes. All right.
Mike Wilmer. Money ain't nothing but money. When you get to the money, it ain't nothing but money. Love ain't nothing but love. When you learn how to love, it ain't nothing but love. Party ain't nothing but a party when you party.
Alright guys, so that's about as cleared out as I needed to apply the conditioner. I don't really like combing or brushing my hair wet, so that's why I use the big teeth comb instead of like a small teeth comb to avoid any like added breakage or too much breakage. But I just needed to clear out that stringy look so the conditioner could really get through. It still feels a bit tangled, but once I put the conditioner on, it will soften it up. So I'm going to put this conditioner on and then like run the comb through it again so that it could have like an even distribution. I don't really need my towel for this, so I just want to show you guys. So my hair is still part in two. Sometimes I do it in four. It's just easier to manage that way. You can probably see the length of my hair now from here, but it really does need a trim, so we're not gonna go by that. But I'm just gonna rub this conditioner on my hair like this. And I do not like use this sparingly. I use this a lot. That's one of the good things about home care. Like, you don't have to worry about the salon or beautician like skimping on what they use on your hair, because you could use as much as you want because it's yours. So, and I still have a lot of my hair like pulling out on my hand, so this isn't good. This is a sign that I just was not doing well on this hair journey, and it can also be a sign that my body isn't properly nourished. And that could be true because, like I said, I haven't been drinking a lot of water. Trying to do better with that. Haven't been taking my vitamins like I should. Trying to do better with that. And I probably have not been treating my hair like I should as well. So I'm just running this replenishing conditioner all through my hair. And now I'm going to do it on this side. And it's already softening up my hair. And just to show you guys like how much I'm using. Like, I am not using no dime size. Like, I'm going in with this. It's our party, we can do what we want. It's our party, we can say what we want. It's our party, we can love what we want. We can kiss who we want. We can screw what we want. Alright, so that's there, and now I am going to prep my heating cap so I can go under that for 45 minutes. Alright guys, so this is the thermal heating wrap. Just instructions. I used this before, but I just package everything back like it came. So in here, they would send you, these are the heating pots. You actually would microwave these. Well, this is where the heat comes from, actually. This is bright enough for you guys to see. And so now what I have to do is like put them in here, put the heating packs in here, and then I put it in the microwave to heat up. And basically these sides, they go in here. I'll have to fix it better like that. Those sides go in there like that. And then this goes like in the middle. So I'm gonna put it in and then heat it up. Round and round and away we go. Round and round and away we go. 4x4 and away we go. High not low and away we go. Round and round and away we go. And away we go and away we go. Alright guys, so I have my hair therapy thermal wrap. You would let this microwave for about 45 minutes on high heat, and then you let it sit for 30. I've already done both, so now I'm going to put this on. And I still have problems like trying to figure out how to put this on. So I think it goes something like this. And then it's like, I did it wrong. The way I was thinking was the correct way. So it goes on like this. And then you just wrap. I'm pulling mine really tight and trying to tuck my hair in it as best as possible. And then you pull here. And it has the Velcro, so it latches there. Now it has a Velcro piece for it to join, but my head is smaller, so to get it tighter, I just do it on the towel portion of it. So now it's on and I can feel the heat, not too much heat. This deep conditioner says to leave on here 45 minutes without heat, 10 to 15 minutes under the dryer. But like I said, I think I really need this, so I'm going to leave this on for 45 minutes either way. And while I do that, I'm just going to relax a bit. Hopefully I don't fall asleep, but if I do, I'm going to get back up and do the next treatment in a minute. So alright guys, so I actually did fall asleep and the nap was too short. But alright, so now I'm going to wash off the treatment. My hair is still warm, so I'm just going to leave this on until I get into the shower. But you could see, it looks like my hair took. And then that's just the treatment for that. So I'm going to go wash this off, wash this out, and then I'm going to put in the next treatment. I'm tired now. This literally takes like all day doing it yourself. Whew. Alright guys, so this is my hair now that I've rinsed out the protein treatment that I had in for about 45 minutes. Now I'm going to put in the Elastic QP Deep Penetrating Conditioner, which is a moisturizing conditioner. Alright, so now I'm gonna put this in my hair. I just wanna comb out the ends a little bit. And as you can see, I'm using the big teeth comb. I hope you guys can hear me. There's a lot of noise outside, so I apologize for that. Alright, so now I'm going to take this little bit left of the Elastic QP and basically use all of it. Gonna apply it just how I applied the organic root stimulator replenishing conditioner for protein, starting from the bottom, working all the way up, and catching all the edges like that. Hey. washed out the Elastic QB Deep Penetrating Moisturizing Conditioner. I love that stuff, like, so much. Remember how my hair looked when I came up, when it was, like, just relaxed and it was all stringy and hard? It wasn't cute. After the Deep Penetrating Conditioner, it's nice and soft. After I put the Deep Penetrating Conditioner on, I just went and, like, heated up the hair wrap again, this, and then I put it on for 45 minutes and I literally went to sleep. This is why I love this, because it doesn't restrict you like a hair dryer does, but you're still getting that deep conditioning with the heat going through the hair follicles and whatnot. But like, I'm able to do so much stuff walking around with this on my head as opposed to having to sit under the dryer. So I'm not gonna really do anything with my hair. I'm just gonna let this dry out for a minute, and then I'm gonna go and get it braided, like, in 4 big braids. That's it. And in the morning, I'm gonna loose it out and it'll be wavy. I'm just gonna let it air dry. I'm not gonna add any more heat to it, because like I said, for the past month or maybe more, I've just been putting my hair through a lot of heat, especially with the clip-ins, and I'm not proud of that. And even though I did expect some shedding, this was a lot, so I don't want to do that. So I'm going to spray in my olive oil mango butter leave-in conditioner. And I hope you guys see why, like, hair journeys are so much work and why I've been, like, falling off, because this literally took all day. Like, I didn't leave my house all day. I haven't even eaten nothing good yet, like a real hot meal. I ate breakfast, like, before I went to sleep, but, like, I haven't eaten yet, and it's already... It's already 5:40. So this literally takes all day with the 2 treatments and being in and out. And I know I relaxed my hair today, but it isn't much different on a shampoo day. On my, like, shampoo days, what I have Sundays allotted for, it really isn't much different, because you have to do, like, the 2 treatments and whatnot. So it does take, and like, each one of the treatments will, depending on how damaged your hair is, the protein treatment doesn't, you wouldn't need 45 minutes with that, but the moisturizing treatment is 45 minutes, and that in itself is almost an hour. And then if you do the protein treatment for about 30 minutes, you know, that's like half an hour. So it takes time. It takes a whole lot of time, and I regularly don't have that much time, and that's why I've been, like, falling off my hair journey so bad, because I don't have just, like, days to just be home trying to keep, you know, wash my hair and do all that other stuff. But I'm really gonna make a conscious effort this year. So guys, like I said, I'm just gonna go ahead now and let this dry out a little bit more, because it's still pretty wet, still pretty damp. And then I'm going to get it braided in 4 cornrows. I'm going to have someone do it for me, because I can't braid. And then after that, well, in the morning, I'll show you me taking it down. But that's it for today, for Sunday. And then the next time I'll have to wash my hair would be Wednesday, when I would co-wash. So I'll record that Wednesday night. Or Wednesday day, depending on my schedule again. But alright guys, so this is day 1 of week 1 of my hair vlogs. I hope you guys enjoy this. Thanks for bearing my very tired, very popped down looking face. My eyebrows need to do. And my face has been breaking out, so I need to get that under control. But I think it's because of the drippings and my hair needing to perm and wash and do all that. All right, guys. So I'll see you on another day in another video. Bye for now.